In the last lecture, we studied the Daniell seal, its half reaction, half cell reaction, okay, oxidation half cell reaction, reduction half cell reaction, and cell representation and cell reaction. Okay, so there we also learned in which half cell is going to be oxidation reaction, in which half cell there is going to be a reduction reaction. So all we have studied in the last lecture. Now if you are jumping directly to this video, you will not understand anything, so make sure that you studied the first one. So today's topic is to calculate the EMF of the Daniell seal, okay, using the standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, so first of all, let me write this one. Okay, it is my Daniell seal. Okay, so this is zinc electrode, this is copper electrode. Now here this is my negative charge, isn't it? This is my positive, and here there will be oxidation. Okay, oxidation reaction, and this is anode. Okay, and this is reduction reaction, and this is my cathode. Okay, so how to decide there is anode, there is oxidation, how to decide there is reduction, that we have studied last time. So, and this is my right, isn't it? This is right seal and this is left seal. So, to calculate the ECL, that is EMF or potential difference between this, like this seal and this seal, we have to calculate with the formula. This is E cell is equal to E right minus E left. Okay, so always we calculate from this formula. Okay, we take the EMF of right and EMF of left and we subtract, then we get the E cell. Okay, so what is happening in the right, please remember. So here in this here it is happening, Cu 2 plus is getting 2 electron and reduced to copper solid, and this is my aqueous, right? And here what is going to happen is, here we have got zinc, okay, which loses, okay, this zinc 2 plus and plus 2 electron. Okay, so this is solid and this is aqueous. We have done this. Okay, so this is oxidation, this zinc is oxidized to Zn2 plus, and this is reduction, that is Cu2 plus is reduced to Cu solid. Okay, now very important thing is there, the E cell, okay, E cell is always of reduction, always of reduction reaction. Please remember, this is very very important. We have to take E cell always of the reduction reaction. Okay, E cell has to be always and always reduction reaction. But here what is happening, oxidation. Okay, so let, okay, now I will tell how to do this. Let me go to the right now. Okay, so let me go to E right. E right is equal to E, what is happening here, it is reduction. Okay, reduced, Cu2 plus is reduced to copper. So I will write this, Cu2 plus reduced to copper. Okay, now what is E right, I mean E left is equal to E, and in fact what is happening here, it is being Zn is oxidized to Zn2 plus, okay, this is oxidation, isn't it? But if you see here, E cell is always a reduction reaction. So this is oxidation, so this is wrong. Okay, we don't take this. So what we take is E left is equal to E, I will write this, okay, Zn2 plus here and Zn here, and this is right. Because now Zn2 plus is becoming Zn, that is it is reduction, like this Cu2 plus reduced to Cu. Okay, so this is Zn oxidized to Zn2 plus. So it is not correct. We don't take the E cell of oxidation. We always take the E cell of reduction. So if I put all this value, then what do I get? Here I get E cell is equal to, E cell will be equal to, what is my E right? E right is E Cu2 plus Cu minus E Zn2 plus 2 Zn, right? So this is my simply the final equation. So what is my final equation? The final equation E cell is equal to E, what is right? Right mein kya hai? Right mein hai Cu 2 plus se reduce over Cu minus oxidation hai, lekin hame kiska nikalna hai? Reduction ka. So ye ho gaya Zn 2 plus reduced over ke Zn ho gaya hai. So this is how we can calculate. Now to calculate E of Cu 2 plus Cu and E of Zn 2 plus and Zn is very difficult. So now how to calculate? What is the easy way? Easy way is to calculate through standard values. Okay, so that is why we take the standard, STANDARD, standard electrode potential. So standard electrode potential, we calculate it from standard electrode potential. And for standard electrode potential, the representation is same, E cell naught. Okay, for standard will be equal to E Cu 2 plus 2 Cu standard minus E Zn 2 plus and Zn standard. So this is how we are going to calculate. Now what do I mean by standard now? Okay, so standard means temperature has to be standard, that is 25 degree centigrade or 298 Kelvin. Or pressure will also be standard, that is 1 bar. And we'll take concentration. Concentration will also be 1 moles. Okay, so standard means each and everything. The temperature of the system will be 298 Kelvin. Pressure of the system will be 1 bar. Concentration of all this, okay, all these solutions, all this electrolyte, all these metals, all this electrode will become 1 mole. Okay, and to calculate standard electrode potential, we use standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, how we calculate standard electrode potential? We calculate it by using standard hydrogen electrode SHEC. And this is my standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, here the pressure is 1 bar, concentration is 1 mole, and temperature is 25 degree centigrade. So this is my standard hydrogen electrode. So using this we calculate the E cells. Okay, standard electric potential of Daniell cell. Okay, so how to calculate? So to do so, let me introduce the SHE, that is standard hydrogen electrode. So in standard hydrogen electrode, there is an electrolyte, and the electrolyte is H plus ion. What is electrolyte? H plus ion. And we have got a test tube though. So this is test tube from where we bubble the hydrogen, that is H2 gas. What do? We bubble the hydrogen gas into this one, right? So the pressure of this hydrogen gas is 1 bar because this is my standard one. And inside this, there is an electrode of platinum. Platinum, it is a metal. So there is electrode of platinum. This is also a platinum. Okay. So let me go to the half cell reaction. Okay, half cell reaction of what? half cell reaction of this standard hydrogen electrode. See, half cell reaction of Daniell cell is this one, isn't it? And half cell reaction of Daniell cell is this one. For right is this, for left is this. Okay, for this one, let me go to the half cell reaction. Okay, so half cell reaction, okay, half cell reaction of SHE. So what is there? There is hydrogen gas, hydrogen ion. So there is hydrogen ion, which is aqueous, okay, and it will get one electron and it will become hydrogen gas, H2 gas. Okay, so this is my half cell reaction. But if you see here, how many hydrogens are there? Two hydrogens, and here how many hydrogen ion? One. It means that this is not balanced. Okay, how to balance this? You put it two here and two hydrogen ion, two electron will give me S2 gas. Okay, so one simple way is to do 1/2, half of H2. What is H? There are two hydrogen. Okay, then if I divide it, if I make it half, then 2 will become 1. Okay, half S2 is then hydrogen is 1, hydrogen ion is also 1, or simply you can just like this, H plus aqueous plus E will give me S2 gas, but there is 2 hydrogen, here I have only 1 ion, so I will add 2 and 2, so this is. This both are correct. So half cell reaction is done. Okay. Now everything is standard. Pressure 1 bar, temperature 298 Kelvin, and everything. Okay. Concentration is also 1 mole. At standard. Okay. At standard values, the E cell. Okay. E. The standard of SHE. Is equal to 0 volt. This is the very important concept. Okay, it has no potential. Whenever I take each and everything standard values, ESHE is 0. Now very important thing is going to happen. Okay, so this is my half cell reaction. So what a representation of half cell? How to represent half cell? You know this. Okay, How we represented half cell? Half cell we represented like this, Zn and Zn2 plus. We represent it like this, half cell, isn't it? And for this we represent like Cu2 plus and Cu. We have done this in the previous lecture. Okay. Similarly, let me represent half cell of this SHE. Okay. Representation. So let me go representation of SHE. How to represent? Okay, what are the elements there are? There is platinum, which is solid. Okay, and 1 bar is there, isn't it? Then hydrogen gas is there, S2 gas is there. And what is there? We have got the H plus ion. So H plus is my aqueous. This is how we represent. Okay, half cell representation. Now how to calculate E standard Cu2 plus to Cu, E standard Zn2 plus to Zn. Okay, how to calculate all these things? We calculate it by, okay, so this is. Now what we do is, we take this, okay, we take this and place it here. Okay, so what we do, we take this here. Okay, so what is there? Here is my zinc sulfate, and what do I have here? I have a zinc electrode, and we connect this. From this to this we connect, and we put a voltmeter here. What do we put? Voltmeter here, and this has become my right and this has become my left. Now, how to calculate the potential of this? The potential of this is E cell standard, okay, is equal to E right minus E left. Okay, so what is in right? Right, you have got E standard, okay. Zinc is there, so this will become zinc 2 plus 2 zinc, okay, minus of what is there, SHE standard, and there is E cell, right. So again I am telling the potential is always from reduction reaction, okay, not from the oxidation reaction, okay. So that is why this and this is writing, then this is zero at standard values, this will become zero, and this will measure, this will measure 0.676, okay, minus 0.76 volt. So then this will become minus 0.76 volt is equal to E Zn standard 2 plus 2 Zn. Okay, so this is all about what is the value of this is minus 7.6. Okay, now what is the representation of this? This representation, Hopsin representation is here. What we have done? We have done like this. This was zinc and it was becoming Zn 2 plus. Okay, so the representation is Zn and Zn 2 plus. So, and the representation of this representation of, let me of this representation of this standard hydrogen electrode is platinum H2 gas and S plus ion, isn't it? Now cell reaction, how to write the cell reaction? Cell reaction, not cell, cell representation, cell representation. Okay, I have here what? I also have the solvent. Okay, so in Dalian cell, how we had represented, there was zinc and it was becoming zinc 2 plus, and there was a salt bridge and we did like this, and there was a copper 2 plus reduced to Cu. This was the cell representation. Similarly, how to represent this cell? To represent, I have got here Pt and H2 and H plus, isn't it? And there is a salt bridge, this two parallel lines is salt bridge, and what is there? I have got Zn, Zn 2 plus. So this is how you can represent. Okay, so what we got? We got the value of this one. Okay, so we got the value of E Zn 2 plus 2 Zn standard is equals to minus 0.76 volt, that we got. Now next, what to do is we replace this, okay, we replace this with another half cell of the Daniell cell. Okay, Daniell cell ab ami ke garcha yahan nira launcha, that is CuSO4, and this is my this, okay, and then I do this is right and this is left. What is the represent, what is the cell reaction? Cell reaction is cell representation, Cu2 plus is becoming Cu here. Okay, so this part is this. So again, what is E cell for this? Okay, E cell for this is equal to E right minus E left. It is always true. Okay, you have to do it E right minus E left. What is there in right? E right is my copper, this one, okay. So this is all standard and standard. So E standard Cu2 plus 2 Cu minus E standard. What is there in left? SHE and the value of SSE is 0. So this is my E standard cell. So whenever we do this one, it will measure 0.34 volt. What does it measure? It will measure 0.34 volt is equal to E0 Cu2+2 Cu. Okay. So we got the value of this one and we got the value of this one. So how to represent the cell representation here also? Similar to this one. Okay, I will remove this. It is very simple. This was for Daniel cell. It was for Daniel cell. Okay. Again, left is same. Standard hydrogen electrode. PtS2S+. And in this side, what we have? I have got Cu2+2 Cu. So this is how you can represent the cell. Now, what will be? We had like this, okay? What we had is, we had like this, right? So this was like this, okay? I'm making it wrong. There was zinc SO4 and there was CuSO4, okay? And this was my zinc and this was my copper. There was like this and there was what? Oh, salt bridge, okay? And this is my right and this is my left. So we got this. Whenever we put it here, we got how much? Zn2+2 Zn standard, how much we got? -0.76 volt we got. For this we got this, and for this how much we got? E cell of Cu2+2 Cu, we got 0.3 volt, right? Now then what we do is, let me put the values here, okay, in this equation. So this is equation number one. So I get E of cell, that is Daniel cell, is equal to, what is E of Cu? What was my value? This was 0.3 volt minus 0.76 volt. Okay, then this will give me 0.3 volt minus plus 0.76, and this will give me 1.10 volt is my standard potential of Daniel cell. Okay, it is very simple. So we calculated this standard potential from the standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, if you see here, there is one negative value and one positive value. What are the importance of negative and positive value? Okay, if you have positive here, so positive value means what does it mean is easily undergo reduction. Okay, it undergo reduction. If you have any E cell, any potential positive, then you have to understand it is in favor of reduction. Okay, it easily undergo reduction means refused. What does it do? It will refuse oxidation. Okay, now what does this negative means? If easily undergo reduction, then it is easily undergo. If it is reduction, then it is oxidation. Okay, for negative, it is easily undergo oxidation. Then what does it do? It will refuse to undergo reduction. Okay, positive. Okay, positive means reduction, easily undergo reduction and it will oppose oxidation. Negative means easily undergo oxidation and refuse reduction. Okay, thank you.